Okay, children, so here we have the diagram of parallels of latitude. I have made it for your better understanding. So here you can see that again a circular shape representing the earth is given, and the line of the equator is right at the center of the earth. The earth is shown as a little bit tilted here. That's why the equator is looking like as it has shifted a little bit below than what it than its actual place, but it's at the center only. So okay, let's begin now. So latitude is an angular distance at a given point from the equator, and as you can see that these lines of latitude which are parallel, which do not meet each other, they are getting smaller and smaller as they are reaching the pole, and ultimately they are getting confined to a point over here. Same is happening here. The lines, they are getting smaller and smaller. I have made few lines over here just for your understanding as a representative lines. So you see that the equator is the greatest circle over here, and rest of the lines, they are getting smaller in size and shape as they are reaching towards the pole. So the lines are marked off at an interval of 1 degree north from the equator or south from the equator in the southern direction. So it means that overall there are total 90 lines of latitude here in the northern hemisphere and 90 lines of latitude here in the southern hemisphere, making up total of 180 lines in both the hemispheres. And as you can see here that just for the representative reference, I have made the degree in the northern hemisphere as 2040. And two more important points you have to keep in mind, that the equator is the starting line of all the lines of latitude or the parallels of latitude. Therefore, equator has the degree of zero. That is, it starts at, it is considered as the starting point of all the parallels of latitude. So it is counted as 0 degree. Okay. And the another important point is that the parallels of latitude in the northern hemisphere are shown as degree N or degree north latitude, and they are signified by the letter N, which I had told you that they are signified by letter N for showing the northern hemisphere, and they are shown by the letter S, degree S latitude in the southern hemisphere. So this was the overall diagram of parallels of latitude. Next, we move ahead to the important parallels or lines of latitude and followed by its uses. Alright children, so our next diagram is now of the meridians of longitude. Here you can see that the lines are running from North Pole up till the South Pole, and they are running in all the directions of the Earth. And the meridians of longitude are just like the equator, that is, they are the imaginary lines that divides the earth into eastern and western direction. As I had told you already that there are four directions: north, south, east and west. So the meridians of longitude, they divide the earth into eastern and western hemispheres, unlike the parallels of latitude which divide the earth into northern and southern hemisphere. Now the most important point that you have to remember is this: firstly, that these meridians of longitude, they divide the earth into two equal parts again, but not in the northern or southern hemisphere, but in the eastern and western hemisphere. And the latitudinal lines, they had 90 lines in the northern hemisphere and 90 lines in the southern hemisphere, making up the total of 180 lines in both the hemispheres. But the case is different here. There are 180 lines in eastern hemisphere and 180 lines in western hemisphere, making up a total of 360 lines around the whole globe or the earth. Because the circumference of the earth is 360 degree and therefore all the lines of the meridians, they all together make up 360 lines. All the lines are placed at a regular interval of 1 degree each. Here I have taken the distance of 30 degree each between the all the degrees measured here just for the representation. And another important point that you have to remember is that the lines that are located in the eastern hemisphere, they are signified by letter E, okay? And all the lines that are located in the western hemisphere, they are signified by letter W, because E stands for east and W stands for west. Now, as the equator was the starting point of all the parallels of latitude, there's a little bit difference here also. The meridian of longitude, the starting point for all the longitudinal lines, passes near the Greenwich Observatory, which is located near London. And therefore, this line right in the center here, which you can see I have located, I have marked it as 0 degree. This is the line which is assumed to pass near the Greenwich Observatory near London. This is the starting point of all the longitudinal lines. From here, all the longitudinal lines start in the western hemisphere as well as in the, eastern hemisphere as well as in the western hemisphere. So children, you have to keep in mind that to know the exact location of a place, we need to know both the degrees of latitudinal as well as longitudinal lines. Now let's take a look at the different heat zones of the earth and some important latitudinal lines of the latitude. So we start with the poles. The pole at the north direction is known as the North Pole, as you know, and the pole at the southern direction is known as the South Pole. Now come to the latitudinal lines. The first important latitudinal line that lies in the northern hemisphere is the Arctic Circle between the frigid zone and the temperate zone, and its location is at 66.5 degrees north. Then the second important latitudinal line is the Tropic of Cancer, which is lying between the temperate zone and the torrid zone at 23.5 degrees north. Then we have the line of equator, which is at 0 degrees, and it divides the earth into equal halves. Next, we have the Tropic of Capricorn, which is lying between the torrid zone and temperate zone at 23.5 degrees south. And the last one we have, Antarctic Circle, in near the South Pole between temperate and frigid zone at 66.5 degrees south. All the latitudinal lines lying in the northern hemisphere are marked with N letter, and all the latitudinal lines located in the southern hemisphere are marked with the letter S. Now let's move ahead towards different heat zones. Okay, so here also the earth has been shown as divided into three main heat zones. Heat zones means the different regions which are divided of the earth on the basis of the sunlight that they receive. So let's focus on it. Here I have used the blue color for showing the cold regions of the frigid zone, green for showing the moderate zones, and yellow for the hottest zones. Let's talk about the first zone, that is the torrid zone. The torrid zone is considered as the hottest zone of the earth as it receives the direct rays of the sunlight, and it stretches between the Tropic of Cancer and Tropic of Capricorn at 23.5 degrees north and 23.5 degrees south respectively. It is a hotter zone, and even the major part of the state of Rajasthan from our country lies within this zone, and that is why it is considered as the hottest state of our country. Next, we move towards the temperate zone. The temperate zone lies both in the northern as well as southern hemisphere. In both the hemisphere, it lies between the frigid zone as well as the torrid zone. Here also, temperate zone in the southern hemisphere lies between the frigid zone and the torrid zone. It receives a balanced amount of sunlight, therefore making the region neither too hot nor too cold. Then we come to the frigid zone. The frigid zone lies in both the hemispheres. So the frigid zone in the northern hemisphere lies between the North Pole as well as the Arctic Circle in the northern hemisphere, and here in the southern hemisphere it lies between the South Pole and the Antarctic Circle respectively. So this was overall the different heat zones of the Earth, which have different regions or climatic conditions and temperatures according to the amount of sunlight that they receive. Okay, children, so now to understand that why does the different regions of the earth receive different types of climate and temperatures, I've made a small basic diagram here. Here you can see that the sun is placed here right in the center, and as according to its orbit, the earth is at the distance from the sun, and here I have signified the different heat zones of the earth with different colors. Blue, as you can see here, is for the frigid zone, that is the cold zone. Green is for the temperate zone, that is a moderate zone, and yellow is for the torrid zone, that is a hot zone. Now let's talk about the division of different temperatures in different regions of the earth. So as you can see that the sun is stable at its position, but its rays are getting everywhere, it's falling everywhere. So the place or the position where the earth is facing the sun, there that portion, specifically the center portion near the equator, this red line signifies equator. This portion, the yellow portion, is facing the direct rays of the sun, whereas the rays are getting a little bit slanted, means inclined towards the poles. They are getting a little bit inclined or tilted towards the pole, and therefore this region is the temperate zone, having the moderate zone, because the rays are not direct here and they are not even passing through it. Therefore the temperature here is very much likely for the people to settle down here more often. It's balanced, it's moderate, neither too hot nor too cold. But that till the time the sun rays reaches the pole, is it actually passes through the poles, across the poles, and therefore this region is always covered with the ice caps, both at the North Pole as well as the South Pole. So that is why the rays are getting diverted here, and this region always, these two regions always remain cold and covered with glaciers and ice caps, and has a lot of icebergs in comparison to these both regions. They don't have it. So this area is the hottest area on the earth, as it is facing and having the direct rays of the sun. This is the temperate zone. It has a moderate type of a climate. The sun rays are neither direct nor they are too much diverted. They are falling perfectly in required amount on this region. Then, till the time it reaches the pole, it actually crosses through it and passes it, so the region does not receive as much of a sunlight, and the region here remains mostly cold throughout the year. So this is the reason why basically different regions of the earth have different type of climate and temperature and different zones.
So children, this was all about this chapter. I hope the concept of grid lines, globe, its features, the latitudinal lines, the longitudinal lines, the heat zones, and the distribution of sunlight, which affects the different temperatures over our planet, everything is clear to you. That's all for this video. Thank you. Have a good day.